Hi guys, welcome to Techie DIY. In today's video, I'm going to look at the MDP-XP mini LED power supply, which was sent to me by Sainsmart. It's made by Miniware. The purpose of the MDP-XP is to take the output from a fixed voltage power supply and turn it into a 0 to 30 volt adjustable output. The features include voltage and current measurement, constant voltage and constant current outputs. It can be connected to a wide range of power sources with outputs between 4.2 and 30 volts DC. It comes with two modules. First, a DC power supply module, which can provide up to 90 watts of output power, a maximum output voltage of 30 volts, and current up to 5 amps. And secondly, a display module with a 2.8 inch TFT screen. The two modules are cased in CNC machined aluminium shells, and they stack together with magnets holding them in place. The modules communicate with each other using a 2.4 GHz wireless connection, and so they can be separated and the power supply operated remotely. The display can control up to 6 other modules. Currently only the power supply is available, but in the future Miniware have said they're developing other types, including a digital signal generator, electronic load, power charger, and a battery pack. The power supply module can be operated independently. It has a liquid crystal display, 3 buttons, and a rotary encoder thumb wheel. On the input side, there is a USB Type-C connector, which supports Quick Connect 3, and a DC barrel connector. The input voltage range is between 4.2 volts and 30 volts DC, and an input current of up to 6 amps. On the output side, there are two 4mm banana sockets made from copper alloy. The module is supplied with two leads terminated with banana plugs and croc clips. You can unscrew the rings to fit wires or ring terminals. On the back of the module, there is a 2.5mm socket which is used to supply power to the display module. The power supply module is turned on by pressing the run button. The display shows the output voltage set point, the current set point, the power and the output status. The set button toggles between the voltage set point and the current set point. Values can be changed with the encoder, the voltage in 10 millivolt increments and the current in 1 milliamp increments. Holding the set button increases the step size to 0.3 volts and 30 milliamps. You can also select from 10 predefined values by holding the set button until it beeps, and then quickly pressing the menu button, scrolling through the options with the encoder and confirming with a set button or exit with the menu button. The voltage and current set values can be locked by pressing and holding the run stroke lock button. The red lock LED indicates the lock status and the lock can be removed with another long press. Pressing and holding the menu button displays a menu with three options: the input current limit, the device wireless address and the beep volume. The wireless address is used to link to the display module. To set the input current limit, press set, change the value with the encoder, the value can be between 1 and 6 amps, and then press set again to confirm. This is useful if you're using something like a USB power bank or stick that can only supply a limited amount of current and perhaps doesn't have a good overcurrent protection. Press the run button to turn on the power. The banana sockets light up to indicate that the power is on, and the display shows the real-time output voltage, current and power. The V or the I in angled brackets shows whether the voltage or current set point is selected, and you can swap between the set points and change the values in the same way as before. The upper blue LED indicates that the output is in the constant voltage state, and when it turns red, it indicates that the output is in the constant current state. Pressing the menu button quickly displays some basic parameters: input voltage, input current, the input current limit setting, the device temperature, and finally the device ID, hardware, and firmware versions. Power is supplied to the display module with a small micro USB to 2.5mm jack plug cable, and then the two units are linked by selecting config and auto match on the display module, holding down the menu button on the power module, scrolling to transmit and receive address, and then pressing the set button and confirm on the display module. Turning on the output, there is a voltage and current graph. The setup section displays the voltage and current set points. The input section shows the input voltage and current. Up to 6 different sets of device parameters can be shown. There are 5 menu buttons and 2 scroll wheels, one for selecting menu items, the other for changing values. The modify button is pressed to change the voltage and current set points. The forward and backward buttons move the highlighted cursor between the two. The menu scroll wheel is used to navigate to the required digit. and then it can be changed with the value scroll wheel. The back button takes you back to the main menu. It also just times out after a short period, which is quite annoying. The info button gives you a table view, and you can modify the set points by pressing modify in the same way as before. Escape takes us back to the main menu. The graph is automatically adjusted to display the maximum and minimum values. The time base can be changed with the menu scroll wheel. The hold key freezes the graph and play resumes. Press and hold the config button to take a screenshot. You can do this in any of the screens. The files can be accessed by connecting the display module via USB to a PC and accessing the file system. The screenshots are 320 by 240 pixels. The rxaddress.txt file contains the wireless address. To check the display module's firmware version, press the config key, use the menu wheel to select more, press the confirm button, and it then displays the serial ID, device name, and the firmware version. This unit was supplied with the latest firmware version, so no upgrade was necessary, but the procedure is as follows. First, download the latest firmware files from the Miniware forum. I'll put a link in the video description. Unzip the MDP-M01 file. Then on the display module, hold the A button while connecting the micro USB port to a computer. A DFU disk will appear. Copy the hex firmware file to the root directory. And then when the hex file extension has changed to a ready extension, the device can be restarted. It's similar with the power module. Unzip the MDP P905 file. Then connect the power module to a computer with a Type-C USB cable. Press the run button while holding down the set button. A DFU disk will appear and the hex file can be copied over. If you connect the power module USB port to a computer and press the run button, a disk called MDP P905 appears. This contains a file called qset.txt, which is where you can modify the quickset values, and a file called rxaddress.txt, where you can modify the wireless address. Now let's measure the accuracy. The MDP-XP is powered from a 13.8 volt linear supply with no load on the output. The output voltage is set to 10 millivolts, and we're reading 10.26 millivolts, so that's good. Let's increase the output to 100 millivolts. And we get a reading of 100.14 millivolts, which is also good. Now let's try 500 millivolts. And that gives 499.27 millivolts, a difference of 730 microvolts. 1 volt is pretty much spot on. Five volts is 5.0017. 10 volts is 10.00161. That's a 1.6 millivolts difference. Twenty volts is 19.99951 volts. 30 volts is 29.99215 volts, which is 7.8 millivolts low. Now let's try it with a 40 ohm load. For a 10 millivolt setting, we get a 10.31 millivolt reading. For 100 millivolts, 100.18 millivolts. 1 volt is pretty much dead on. 5 volts is 5.00069 volts. 10 volts is 10.00218 volts. 20 volts is 20.00034 volts. And 30 volts is 29.99320 volts. Now let's check the current into a 10 ohm load. Setting the output to 100 milliamps gives a 99 milliamp reading. 500 milliamps gives a 498 milliamp reading. 1000 milliamps gives a 996 milliamp reading. 2 amps gives a 1.994 amp reading. So that's all good. Now let's connect up the scope and see what happens when we turn on the output. The MDP-XP is set to 5 volts and its output is unloaded. The scope is set to 1 volt per division and 5 milliseconds per division. Let's turn it on. And it takes less than 5 milliseconds to reach 5 volts and it doesn't overshoot. Now let's try it with a 40 ohm load and the same oscilloscope settings. It takes about 10 milliseconds to come up to 5 volts and again it doesn't overshoot. Now a 10 ohm load with the time base set to 10 milliseconds per division. It takes 40 milliseconds to reach 5 volts and it doesn't overshoot. Let's try the same thing with a 30 volt output setting. First with no load and the time base set to 10 milliseconds per division. It takes 30 milliseconds to reach 30 volts and no overshoot. Next a 40 ohm load with 100 milliseconds per division. It takes 30 milliseconds to reach 30 volts and no overshoot. And finally a 10 ohm load with 200 milliseconds per division. That took 600 milliseconds to reach 30 volts and no overshoot. So that's all fairly well behaved. Next let's have a look at ripple and noise. I've got the scope hooked up to the output. And as soon as the MDP-XP is turned on, we get some noise on the output. This is roughly 3 millivolts peak to peak, and it doesn't make much difference whether the output is turned on or off. To measure the output properly, you would normally use a low voltage differential probe to reject common mode noise and determine how much noise is actually present on the output. Unfortunately, they're very expensive. All that being said, the noise level is pretty low anyway. I've also had a look at the noise using the FFT function of the scope, and you can see a 50Hz spike, which was there before the MDP-XP was switched on, along with a 1.5MHz spike, and then harmonics at 3, 4.5, 6MHz, etc. 1.5MHz appears to be the switching frequency. So overall the noise is pretty low and it's a good result. I've been using this for a while now and I really like it. On the positive side, it's small, accurate, beautifully made, and capable of supplying 30 volts and up to 5 amps, which is ideal for most of the circuits that I work on. It's convenient to be able to use it on the desk, powered by a USB power supply, or to take it with me powered by a USB power bank or battery. It's fairly bulletproof. I've abused it with accidental reverse polarity, over voltage, short circuits, etc., and it has survived. On the negative side, it's not the cheapest lab power supply. The display module also doesn't add much capability to the power module. If you add further modules, then it makes more sense. The ability to operate the power module remotely from the display module could be useful in some situations. The controls also need some refinement, adding acceleration to the thumb wheels and sorting out the annoying timeout on the display module. I also seem to find myself naturally turning the wheels in the wrong direction, so the option to configure the control directions would be useful. Miniware have said that they will release the firmware as open source software at some point, which will make it easier to fix some of these niggles and add features. But overall, this is a great little power supply and I'm happy to recommend it. So that's it from me. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.